Thieves. Man, the first time we heard about one of these knives, yeah, that was a folder.
Okay, guys, today I'm going to sound like a salesman, because when I find something that I really love and I really believe in, I can't help but express it. This knife runs about $400, worth every penny.
All right, Kato, to be fair to this guy, I can understand why a knife can be worth every penny in this price range, because we won a Rockstead. But nevertheless, the only thing that we thought was that it was extremely overpriced, and yeah, we couldn't understand why it was so expensive. We've gotten hold of the Chris Reeve Green Beret. The steel is CPM S35VN, but only hardened up to 57 HRC. Man, that is soft! So today we're gonna see if Chris Reeve is overpriced or not.
Huh? That's demonetization right there.
Okay, can I just very quickly mention the giveaway, because we're doing like the biggest one ever, because we're giving away the whole Falkniven line and yeah, a couple of more knives. So link is in the description. Thank you very much. So you're telling me that this knife is 55 to 57 HRC. Ladies and gentlemen, that is very soft for steel.
It's a Chris Reeve knife from a subscriber.
And Armo.
He gifted it to me.
We're gonna keep this very simple, because Chris Reeves has got the reputation in our eyes of having overpriced knives. Why?
Yeah, simple steels.
Do you know what we're gonna do? We're just gonna test this knife, open-minded. We didn't script any of this. We're just gonna do our DBK tests and see what we think of this knife. What else can I say about it? Yeah. I think let's just put it through hell. This is a military knife. We gotta put it through hell. We are gonna try to kind of like destroy the knife, aren't we, or not?
This $400 knife.
Yeah.
Like, why should we want to destroy it?
Just let's see how far it can go.
Okay.
First test. Edge retention.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, real good. Good.
Yeah, that's just good.
Where the problem started already. Marta could not get more than two cuts done with this knife. Two! That's nothing!
Oh no!
This might be the hardest I've ever done. This is just not toothy. Really not toothy.
Okay, so two cuts for this knife as a trapper. So because this knife was an S35VN knife, it seemed like a good idea to make it a face-off with one of my S30V knives. A knife that we haven't seen in a long while. The Enzo Trapper. Yeah.
Your trapper, your parade, Mickey.
Good to see you back, old friend. You know, I dropped this knife like 4 years ago in a video and it lost this point. And I think only 2 months ago I resharpened the point. Oh, very nice, perfect edge. Where's the bloody paper? It's raining and all my knives are lying outside. First, the Enzo Trapper, which had cost me around 140 euros. Yeah? Perfect.
Yeah, that's still really good.
A few little nicks, not racist. The Chris Reeves $325 knife. Pretty shit. Let's go to the harder use tests.
This is pretty good. I mean, the shape, I mean, it goes from really thin to really thick, so it does really split the wood.
I'll try a thicker piece, look. Little hardcore.
Beam.
Whoa, that looks really good. What grade would you give it? What would you rate it?
You know, this... We have so many grades, it's hard now to make a good grade. I mean, for a knife this size, I would definitely give it an 8.
Yeah, I was also thinking an 8 if I was looking at this. Let's grab like a real nasty piece.
Capable. I found a nasty piece. Put a long piece like this here. Whoa, whoa. That came off.
Holy shit, that is pretty crazy.
Ready?
Whoa!
Okay, now I'm gonna just baton right through the knot. Just... That's crazy.
Martin, this might be an 8.5. I must say, this is an 8.5.
It is. I don't know why, but it's a crazy good batoner.
Because there's so much space in the handle, Martin. I want to throw it against the board. See if the handle will come loose. Because that is unacceptable for a military knife, isn't it? Isn't it?
Yeah. Nothing changed.
Nothing?
Nothing. Point still straight. I'm still straight.
No, I'm a little bit. I'm a little bit gayer since the start of this test.
To say is, you can say what you want, like you can say I'm a banana, but that won't help because these are really nice feathers. But you know what? I don't like this. This, look, this.
Yeah.
That's this. Yes, look, this is sitting in my hand like that. Does this look comfortable? Does this look like your grandma's couch?
No. It looks a little bit like a banana.
Yeah, what can I say? I still scrape 1 out of 10.
Wow, I do that helemaal niet.
With a lot of force, but you're not gonna make a fire with that, man. Here it is, I found it, it's in the handle.
What the hell? What the hell?
Because this is actually not rounded, I think.
I made fire with a handle. This is literally the first time that we ever made a fire with the handle of a knife.
quick intervention. Because look, Martin's audio was sounding like this.
Flesh, the meat.
And basically what he was saying is that Martin had surprised me with a piece of meat that I didn't know what it was. He told me it was going to be something really special. So, oh yeah, this was my reaction.
This was 20 euros, this little piece of meat. It's a lamb's rack.
Whoa! Oh, let me take it. Oh,
that's good stuff, isn't it?
Oh, that looks really good.
Smell. Oh, that
That look, oh my god, that... I really can't wait to eat this. We really gotta hurry up, Martin, because it is actually starting to rain. And the forecast is that it's not gonna rain softly.
Oh, and my mobile phone just died yesterday because of rain.
Let's go!
What a young beast. I think this one should be done.
I am out of...
Martin. Gast. Look at this, perfect.
Whoa. That is so unbelievably nice.
That is tender as hell.
Oh my god.
Whoa.
Martin, oh.
That is amazing.
This is,
Oh, whoa.
I didn't expect this to be so tender right off the fire.
Martin, this...
Is this tastes like slow cooked.
We just casually made a piece of meat. What I want to say is that this is one of the most, one of the nicest pieces of meat that I've ever eaten in my life.
Really?
Suddenly in this video, this has happened.
You always were from a poor family.
Martin, are you ready?
Scary part. Yeah?
Yeah. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Okay.
Whoa. That's no, but that is actually much tougher than I thought.
Okay, then now I'm going to stand on the, right here, yeah?
Yeah, show it again.
Right here. Okay. So the, where that bar meets the handle.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
It's holding it.
Holy sh! Okay, Martin, that is really surprising.
Okay.
Yeah, well, conclusion. Holy shit, say, that is really good.
55 HRC is good for something.
Ladies and gentlemen, have you checked out our giveaway that we do every month, every single month, also this month that you are watching right now? Just head up to the Patreon link in the description and have a chance to win a
all-new Falkneven R2 and LMAX. The Falkneven F1X, the Falkneven S1X, thanks to Bailey's Q, the Falkneven A1X, yeah, that's the whole Falkneven series, from small to big, yeah. A Cold Steel SRK, thanks to Cold Steel Deutschland, and last but not least, thanks to Benchmade, a Benchmade Bugout, the ultimate EDC.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, this is our income, so thank you very much for joining the giveaway, and now let's go over to the conclusion for the knife.
Hey, Mickey, I think we can be pretty sure about this knife.
Yeah.
You know, it is an expensive knife. For me, the main thing that a knife should have is a good steel, a good edge, because that's what makes a knife a knife.
Yeah.
And that is the one thing that this knife lacks a little bit in.
Yeah, I mean, we have a lot of overpriced knives. It's all up to personal preference. If you spend like 400 euros, 300 euros on a knife, you want it to be really, really good, no matter what the value is. But this knife is $325 and we don't recommend it for that price. But it is pretty indestructible, isn't it?
It is indestructible. I mean, it looks stabby. I guess in a combat situation, this would be a nice knife.
Yeah. I don't know how much people are in a combat situation.
Not a lot. And it's pretty shitty if you get in one.
Yeah.
But you can baton with it, you can feather stick with it. Fire making was a little bit hard, but it will help you through most of your tasks.
But I do want to say that as a survival knife, I also don't recommend it, because I think a survival knife needs to be able to make a fire.
No.
And you don't want to be like pissing about with your handle fire making. No, you do not want to do
that. Is it a bad knife to take on your combat mission where you might just have a lot of other things at hand? It's a fine knife to take on your combat.
It's a really good knife.
It's not going to break on you.
But ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe, visit our Patreon. Hey, check out my bed. But I don't want to say anything about that anymore, because otherwise Mark's going to get really angry. Mm. And what else? Yeah. Oh, every Thursday, 1 p.m. PDT. That's the most important thing.
And if you haven't watched last week's video, we ate surfschomming. Check it out.
So I let a fart this morning. I almost puked.
Surfschomming fart?
Yeah. The surfschomming fart was real. It was real.
Oh, man.